But with every closing chapter, the story is sure to grow richer and deeper. It has been quite a journey we have taken together. And so it is with the heaviest heart that I write this final, unbelievably short sentence as Lady Whistledown. Goodbye.
You're very
He's the most handsome of them all.
Yes.
You are.
Yes.
Queen.
You're so handsome.
I still cannot fully believe you had a boy. And the heir, no less. The new Lord Featherington is quite handsome.
Guess that from his father.
Your father is always trying to distract with a clever word and a beguiling smile.
You think my smile is beguiling?
I'm glad we had daughters.
I'm certain they will both marry very well.
I think little Philomena will one day become a great writer without any need of a husband.
Well, it certainly runs in the family. I could not have written my book without the help of Philomena's auntie Penelope.
It is better than I expected.
Are you old enough to read that?
Yes.
It is here! I got almost enough for everyone.
Oh, thank you.
And with the retirement of my literary persona, I should like to formally introduce myself. Previous wallflower, current columnist, observer, wielder of a quill. Nobody unique, and yet I have my moments.
And hopefully, dear reader, you will stay on to enjoy them with me as we begin this next part of our journey. Yours truly, Penelope Bridgerton.
What is the primary force that guides us along our paths?
Penelope.
Is it our minds or our hearts?